श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अननोइंगली वी ऑल नो, बट वी डू नॉट नो दैट वी नो। कैन देर बी ए बेटर जोक ऑफ फुलिशनेस देन दिस? वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट मेडिटेशन, एनी टॉम डिक एंड हैरी वॉन्ट्स टू सिट क्वाइट बिकॉज द ट्रूथ इज wherever there is movement, there is samsara. Where there is no movement, there is Paramatma. See? This is meditation. Earth moves, water moves, fire moves, air moves. Space doesn't. And can these movements in these four happen without the space? If there is no space, where will these four things exist? There was one intelligent son, and his mother was old, illiterate. Many times we feel smart people are intelligent. No, smart people are walking. In Hindi it is called a chalu. They are not intelligent. They are street smart. So he told his mother, Mama, do you know I am doing research? So she said, what is this research? No, I want to discover something. Oh, what you want to discover? I want to discover or create one liquid in which everything will be dissolved. So the mother said, my dear son, where will you keep it? When everything is dissolved, where will you keep it? See, so the first principle, remember, and I am not imposing anything on you. You have to learn from yourself. See, my spiritual approach to life is not theoretical. Learn from your experiences. And that is your guru. Don't go and hang on to a person and suffer throughout life. Hey guru, nothing is going to happen. Gurus are not mule to carry the disciples. You learn from your experiences of life. So is it not our experience? All movements are possible on the foundation of that which doesn't move. And therefore, we may ask a question, where is earth, where is water, where is fire, where is air? Has anybody ever asked this question, where is space? Now, apply it to yourself. You ask about every damn thing in this world. Where is heaven? Where is hell? What is that? What is this? You have no question about your own being, and that is the truth. But instead of holding on to the truth, we get lost in this world. See? And this happens only because these four elements outside, earth, water, fire, air, they are in us. Body is earth. All the liquids in the body, blood, juices, lymph, they are waters. See? Then hunger, thirst, this is fire. Desire, anger, frustration, depression, this is air. Where are they? They are in that which doesn't have any of the four things. Now tell me what sadhana, what meditation you want to do. Therefore, don't do meditation. Live in this awareness. See, friends, those who are too much body oriented, they are engaged in doing physical work. Those who are too much world oriented, they are engaged in do seva, seva, seva. Those who are too much mind oriented, they are told, oh, upasana karo, upasana karo. It is something like that. I want to sit in that huge giant wheel, but I should not feel. When you are sitting in the giant wheel, you will feel the suffering. When it comes down, oh, it will happen. You can't stop it. Therefore, the first step in meditation is to be fully convinced of this fact. Freedom from body identification. This I will keep on telling you shamelessly till you get disgusted. There is no way out. One person told me, Swami, you tell again and again, don't you feel bored about that? I asked him, I said, you know, how is your son? Oh, Swami, he is doing very well. And then he started telling about his son. Then I said, stop a moment. How many times you told about your son? He is so intelligent, he asks so many questions, he is the best student in his school, he is first. One mother told me, Swami, my son is in class 1 and he stood first. So I asked the child, hey, congratulations, how many students are there in your class? Only one. Even if you want, you can't be second. I said, when you keep on talking about your children, don't you get disgusted? Friends, just observe this. We talk about our life, how many times? Forget that. We look into that mirror, how many times? Has anybody ever said, come on, you have the same face every day, I don't want to look at it? No. Everybody is 80, not out. Even then, no, it is beautiful. Because I am there. See, friends. And this I has never changed. Therefore, all that is changing, we have to drop it and reach the changeless substrate. So, this is a simple technique. And we have to be convinced of this. That meditation means freedom from body identification. But most of the people get lost in this. When I said, I saw the light. But only once it came, thereafter it never came. Swamiji, can you help me? I said, change the bulb. Light. See? These people who are too much exercise oriented, too much of diet oriented. They do dieting, they die eating. And all the time, they want the bones to be wrapped in the skin. See? That is not spiritual life. See? Once I went to one cremation somewhere, someone else's, not mine. So I was standing and the fire was burning. One person asked me, Swamiji, how much time it will take? I said, I don't have experience. Now, what can you see? Any kind of question these people ask? I don't know. He said, I can tell you. I said, maybe your experience? He said, yes. What? He said, this person will take 1.5 hours, less than 2 hours. So how do you know? He said, you don't know this thing? I said, no. He said, when a person is only bones and skin, it takes 6 hours. And if a person is fat and all that, he has got the built-in fuel. So he burns quickly. Therefore, after death, if you want to burn quickly, become fat. If you remain only bony, 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 you will be suffering on that pyre, but you will not be burned. No? Figure karo, figure. How long are we living at the body level? Body, body, body. Come out of it. Only see that your body is available to you whenever you want and don't torture that body. See, friends, you will see there are two types of people who are very angry. One is tapasvis. They do tapasya. Now who asks you to suffer? Enjoy life. And you are all grahasthas, is it not? What should be tapasya for you? First, understand tapasya, austerities. Tapasya is invited problems. In the cold climate, you don't put on warm clothes. Why? Tapasya. When the food is available, you don't eat. No, I am observing fast, 21 days. But after observing fast for 21 days, how come you are so strong still? Because I eat at night. Roja type. See, friends, therefore, wherever there is tapasya, torturing to the body, such people are extremely angry, and tapasvis always curse. See? Like one person asked me, he said, you people become Swami and nicely go by air and in AC cars and lead in a very comfortable place. What kind of spirituality? I said, this is 5-star spirituality. No, we see, we simply slip below the tree and we don't have any possessions. I said, very good. Continue. See? Now, who asked you to do that? Do whatever you like. See? So, these tapasvis have got great anger. And they can curse anytime, anybody. Cursing is possible when the otherness is recognized as right or real. Then, secondly, yogi. Yogis also are very angry type. They cannot tolerate anything. Discipline, strict. Now meditation. Dun, 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 dun. Sit down. Still I ring the next bell, meditate. So what will be the meditation? Oh God, send the bell quickly. Is this meditation? See, meditation is not a military drill. By the left, quick march. Meditation is a conscious effort, practiced effortlessly through wisdom to get rid of body identification. If that is not done, whatever you may do, it is like trying to fill in a pot which is kept upside down and go on pouring any water. Not a drop will enter inside. If this is clear sufficiently, then the question comes, how we proceed. So there are many techniques. I'll tell you one technique today. There is one text, Vijnana Bhairav. My book is there in Hindi. There are 112 meditation techniques given there. And one of them is what I am going to tell you. So before we come back to ourselves and want to withdraw within ourselves, all this process happens through the mind, not through the body. Everything happens through the mind. Now this mind must be capable. And the first capability of the mind is cheerful and happy. A frustrated, angry person, I want to do this, I want to do this. Meditation khatam hone se phir dikhati hu. Will such a person do meditation? See? These frustrated people can never sit in 2 minutes quiet. So, first we must be cheerful and happy. Cheerfulness and happiness is expressed in the eyes. From the eyes you know whether you are at peace with yourself or not. Eyes tell very clearly where you are. There are certain people, maybe something wrong with me or whatever, I cannot look into their eyes. I cannot. As if you know they are going to bounce on you and start eating. Very, you know, as if, you know, jumping out of their body. So first, cheerful and happy, relaxed. Second thing, we are not going to get anything. It is a bargain of 100% loss. See, are you ready for that? What will I get after doing meditation? Headache. Then I can do it. You are not going to get anything. Then, second step. Most of the seekers, they develop a fear psychosis. And the fear is imagined, cultivated, created. How it is? Suppose I sit for meditation and as you tell Swamiji, get out of the body. Suppose I get out of the body and I cannot enter, then you are dead. Yeah. Then what should I do? Hold a hand and get out. They are funny things. When I come across these questions, that's how I am happy. When you see the cartoons, you can never suffer. Then, one person asked me this question. Swamiji, I have been doing levitating meditation. So I always have one problem. If I start levitating, what will happen? I said, look here, that depends where you are sitting. Suppose you are sitting below a fan which is moving at 5,000 revolutions per second. You go there, over. If you are sitting below a tree, you will be hanging there like a fruit. See? Jackfruit. And if you are below nothing, you will straight away go to the heavens. You will go beyond the sphere of gravitational force. Nothing is going to happen. So the third principle, nothing is going to happen. Don't get lost in that imagination. When I said, when something garam garam has gone up, gas thi. only the gas. See, friends, don't get carried away by all these things. Some people say, you know, when I sit, I hear nice in mridangam. What next? I say, iska tabla aega. See, what is happening in this? Objectivity is maintained. Objectivity is maintained because I am still the body. See. Now, after this is over, so how to get rid of this fear? Remember one thing, in our heart, spiritual heart, not the bloody heart. Spiritual heart is the sternum. So here, our beloved Lord and our Guru Maharaj, they are there. You are not alone. The Lord guides us from within. What next? And Guru tells us, don't worry, I am with you. You are not alone. So the fear and guidance is given to us. The freedom from the fear and guidance is given to us by the Lord and the Guru respectively, from within. Then the next step. When we sit, we should be very clear, at this moment I am nobody. Don't sit as anybody. Because who is a nobody? Nobody has no past. Who is somebody who is carrying the burden of the past? Observe this. Whenever we talk about our past, we are talking as somebody. So he insists, now at this moment, remain as nobody. And how do we know whether we are remaining as nobody? If thoughts do not come, you are nobody. If you sit like a husband for meditation, wife will be standing there with a bella in the hand. Dekhti hoon, bahar to aajao. See, this somebody must disappear. So when we remain as nobody, we have no past. Those who are living in the past, in the present, they cannot be happy. There are many people, in their childhood, they have suffered child abuse, or in India, it is the elders torturing, elders scolding. If there are half a dozen children, some child is given preference, the other is not given. All those things built up to such an extent that their present in further future life is completely destroyed. And one important thing, we cannot undo our past. Only one thing we can do, our past, select, shift, delete. There's no other way. Drop it. See? And remain as nobody. So remaining as nobody means the past is blocked. The next important adjustment, psychological. After meditation, what I am going to do, don't plan anything. If you plan after meditation, so many people have come, I think I will make upma. Then whole meditation will be cutting onions. Itne pure ho gaye kya? Nahin, aur le lo. Onion meditation. Don't plan anything what you are going to do after meditation. Now what is the right result? Now you are in the present. Here you have achieved 80% meditation. Because thoughts are of three types. One pertaining to the past, creating somebody. One pertaining to future, called as worries, and trying to solve the non-existing problems. And in the present, we try to compare. Within the meditation, jama tha, jam nahi raha. Comparison. These three things are dropped. You have achieved 80%. Now, if you observe, in whichever posture you are, your body has become firm at the base, vertically it is steady, and the weight of the body has increased on the base. And the breathing is extremely slow and shallow. And if we analyze, in fact, we were not doing meditation, but we were undoing. So we have stopped because remaining miserable, undoing miserable is happy. Undoing fear and questions, no fear, no questions. Undoing somebody, total past gone, and you are nobody. Somebodies are many. Mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, son, daughter. Nobody is only one. So when we undo all bodies, we come to nobody. Then we don't plan anything for the future. So mind has no way to go. But then the mind, because of too much of exposure to all wrong things, starts questioning. Simply sitting, how it can be meditation? I must hear something, I must smell something. And again the mind becomes vibrant. So recognize this basic principle. In meditation, we do not get anything. Because real meditation is that where meditator has disappeared. like real sleep is that where the one who wanted to sleep has disappeared. The one who wanted to sleep, if he is still there, then it is a dream. It is not a sleep. When sleep overpowers, the one who wanted to sleep, he dissolves in the sleep. Exactly the same. The one who wanted to do meditation, he disappears. Therefore, meditation is neither successful nor a failure. Success for whom? For nobody. Failure for whom? For nobody. If we are struggling then we are somebody. Patanjali says, Prayatna Shaithilya. Minimum efforts. Do not concentrate on anything. Simply remain aware that the moment the thoughts erupt, find out to whom the thoughts have come. Immediately that person and the thoughts will disappear in awareness. Do not fight with the mind. Learn to remain indifferent. All thoughts arise after body identification. whatever we give importance to, that alone creates thoughts. If we have given importance and value, we have to devalue that. Nobody can do it for us. Whenever doing and becoming is the criteria, we will be doing meditation. When undoing and unbecoming is the criteria, we will live in meditation. Then meditation will happen. Not to get disturbed by the contents of earth, water, fire and air is not an achievement for the space. It is a natural state. Similarly, vision doesn't get influenced by any color and form. Ears do not get influenced by any word. Mind doesn't get influenced by any thought. And the conscious reality that we are do not get influenced by waking, dream, deep sleep or samadhi. Substratum is always undisturbed. Although supporting all the disturbances, this is our real nature. It doesn't matter how long you sit. What matters is, are you able to be convinced of this? Then we are the substratum, changeless, supporting waking, dream, deep sleep and samadhi. This conviction is living in meditation. Take deep breath 2-3 times slowly. And you now clearly can experience the body and yet uninfluenced by the body. Although experiencing the body, yet remaining apart from and other than the body is living in meditation. As we work through the car, we use the car. But we are clear, we are not the car. To the same extent, we work through the body, but we have to be convinced that we cannot be the body. Move your toes and fingers slowly. Don't vigorously rub your palms. That's a wrong method. Now, the concept that I am inside the body and the world is outside the body has become real. Till such time, this concept of inside and outside is valid, we are in samsara. Here again, we learn from our experience of deep sleep. In deep sleep, we are inside the body or outside the body. We are inside the house or outside the house. We are in USA or India. We are in 2017 or 1947. We are a man or woman. We are mother, father or husband, wife. Everything disappears. Because we are not identified with the body. Therefore, to continue this experience of living in meditation will mean do not interact with the world so strongly that you are taking this world as real. Like an actor acts on the stage. He acts as if things are happening really. But in the heart of his heart, he knows clearly and distinctly. Nothing is happening. So, be a hypocrite when you are conducting yourself in the world. Living with this wisdom is living in meditation. Give it a try. Either enjoy or suffer. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.